Sandler.
Live from Iona College, welcome to Sports Unfiltered on the radio. I'm your host, Jake DeMisa.
I'm Joe Sorrentino.
And I'm Matthew George.
And after a one-month hiatus, basically, we're back. It's been a while.
Better than ever.
Better than ever.
It's called college. It gets in the way of stuff sometimes.
Basically,
you know?
I mean, we're not used to it, obviously, freshman in college, but
yeah,
got to get used to it. It's the way it's going to work.
Soon we're going to be freshmen on the real radio.
Can only hope.
Yeah.
But we're going to start this off with college basketball. Iona Gale started their season last night with a 99-78 loss to ACC opponent Florida State. Obviously, Power 5 conference team, we didn't really expect to win that game. We're more of a mid-major college, we always have been. And our path to the tournament starts in conference play and not right now.
Yeah, they playing a college like FSU last night, they sort of... They looked, you know, like they had some flaws, but like it's a long season, I guess, for college players. So I mean, I think they could get back on track.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. Iona, obviously, their path to the tournament is probably going to run through Monmouth and Siena. One of those three teams will probably wind up in March, and you know they'll be a low seed. That's how it works. We're not one of the Power Five conference teams. We never are going to be, but that doesn't mean we're not a good basketball team.
Maybe one day, you never know.
But we did see something really good last night at Sam Cassell Jr. Son of Sam Cassell, who made the NBA. He had 28 points, transferred from UConn, first year playing here, and, you know, he could actually be a really good piece of this team to make us make a run in March.
Yeah, it's just, it's weird. Isn't it weird how everything works out? His dad played here, and then all of a sudden he goes to UConn. Obviously, that's a huge opportunity. They don't play him, and now his son's playing.
His dad didn't play here. I don't know where he got that information from.
His dad's jersey was in the rafters.
I don't think.
Oh, maybe he played at FSU. Who knows?
Yes, Florida State.
Yeah.
I was gonna say Sam Cassell did not go here. Definitely Florida State.
Especially
since we were playing in Tallahassee last night.
So. Yeah, and then if his jersey was in the so I guess it is weird. I don't know.
But either way, Sam Cassell came here for our red and white scrimmage. He was sitting in the front row, so it's cool that he's gonna be showing up to games for his son. Also, star of this team and leader of this team, Jordan Washington, 16 points last night. He was a big key to the team last year that made the run in March. Or run to March since they got eliminated from Iowa State in the first round. But him, Isaiah Williams, and A.J. English were the three guys that this team really relied on last year. And they're going to look for more production out of guys like John Sevier, out of guys like DeAndre Turner, maybe even off the bench.
Definitely, yeah. And you're close to DeAndre Turner, right? You know him?
Sociology class.
Yeah.
With DeAndre.
Speaking about sociology classes, are we done with Iona? Or are we going to move on?
Go ahead.
Speaking about sociology classes... St. John's University is where I attend. I'm repping it right now. And we're 2-0. We beat the notorious Bethane Cookman 77-61. Or no, we beat Binghamton 77-61. We beat Bethane Cookman 100-53.
That's the difference between Iona and St. John's. St. John's gets to start the season against Cream Puffs because they're in a power conference. Well, we have to play teams like Florida State.
Yeah.
It works.
They've been playing really well. Love it. 21 points per game. It's fun to watch them again. After, you know, I've always wanted to go to St. John's, and it was my dream to go there, and finally getting to go there was pretty cool. But watching them play last year was like watching Oedipus stabbing his eyes out. I didn't want to watch it, but I did. I put myself through it. Chris Mullen, man. I mean, he died. If there is a good thing, he sort of turned the team around, even though it's only two games and we've played bad teams.
You guys have played two terrible teams. Two terrible teams. Horrible year last year. I don't know what you're trying to get at.
I'm saying that. I said we had a horrible year. I acknowledge that. You just can't call
Chris Mullin a good coach yet, though. I mean,
I'm saying Chris Mullin is turning them around slightly. I've met him. He's a nice guy. Same person they booed at Golden State's jersey retirement thing. But I watching them play is fun again. You know, they've turned it back around. I guess make basketball fun again, right?
Just speaking about Chris Mullin. Chris Mullin actually went to my high school, Severian High School, before it actually was named Severian High School. It used to be St. Michael's High School. Shout out to Severian. Just for that.
That's cool. I didn't know that. He went to St. John's too. He's a great player, but
do you think he's gonna be an effective coach? That's the question.
Yeah, like you have to wait to see. You have to watch. It's only gonna take time. You know, a lot of coaches in NCAA athletics, it takes a while for them to get really good. You know, it's hard to adapt to. It's a completely different style of play because Chris Mullin was an NBA player. And he learned the NBA ways for a very long time, and to go back to the college way of playing is sort of,
yeah,
it's a lot. It's a huge difference.
And speaking of players in our colleges, by the way, you got a Tangerine Mussolini in your class.
Yeah, did you just say Mussolini? Are you kidding me?
Well, it was a joke because the guy's last name is Mussolini.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. So it's Mussini.
Point guard from Italy.
Yes, he's in my sociology class. No, it's not Mussolini. he's a nice kid. Nice kid. God, I mean, I've spoken to him so many times. He's really humble. Nice kid. He's not a bad player. What is it, 12 points per game?
Third on the team right now. Through two games. But
yeah, through two games, 12 points per game is not terrible. You know, he's a nice kid. It's cool to see this. Like, cool to make friends with.
Yeah.
Kids that it may eventually be stars.
And college basketball just started. I mean, we really don't know anything about teams yet. It's like this sport, you really don't know anything at the beginning. You have to wait till the middle of the season to even start talking about it.
What was it? Who was it last year that made that run? Hawaii Pacific? Or some weird team made a run last year in the tournament.
I mean, SF Austin.
Okay, Austin. Hawaii beat somebody.
SF Austin led by Thomas Walkup. I mean, they beat West Virginia last year. They almost beat Notre Dame. They lost the buzzer, so.
Mm-hmm.
But Walkup from the D-League right now. He was a really good player in the tournament last year.
You know who's cream puff soft? Speaking of Notre Dame, their football team. All right, let's continue. National championship picks.
Okay. Matt, you want to kick this off?
All right, I'm going with, surprisingly, I don't know if this is underrated or not, UCLA.
Good pick.
I mean, there's one person in particular that I'm actually looking forward to watching is Lonzo LiAngelo Ball. In my perspective, he could be the next Russell Westbrook, to be honest. Because in his first game, I think he got like 19 points, 11 assists, and 8 rebounds. So close to his first triple double in his first game. So. With him running the point and then having an all around great team, I think they can have a good run for this season.
Yeah, UCLA's probably due too. They're one of the most prestigious college basketball teams, and they really haven't done anything in like the last decade. Yeah,
well, they've been great at baseball.
Talking about basketball.
I know, but like, but we're talking about NCAA athletics.
If you want to talk about football, you talk about how they were good at Brent Hundley when he was there. I mean, okay, not what we're saying.
They're still good at baseball. All right. I'll do my national championship pick. I'm going to go Kentucky. After watching them last night, I thought they were... This kid, DeAndre Fox, and I hate to call him a kid because we're the same age, but I always do that. I guess you're growing up in sports culture, so anybody under the age of 30 is a kid still. DeAndre Fox, 15 points per game. I saw him make a layup last night. He was under the basket. There was a guy pressed up against his back, and he pushed him off in the most graceful manner and just laid it in. Just... tapped it in. It's ridiculous. And then Briscoe, he's returning, a returning player. 20 points per game. He's the point leader for the team. They have an all-around really good scoring team. The only thing that scares me a little bit is their defense. But I think Calipari is going to lead. I really do think Kentucky's going to win the national championship.
And Isaiah Briscoe, you brought him up a little bit. He's a sophomore now. He didn't get much time playing time last year because of how stacked that team was. But he's a really talented prospect.
Yeah,
and five-star recruit.
And the whole thing was they were wondering when he was going to play last year, even though he was a freshman. They were saying it a lot. And we saw him on the court maybe, what was it, maybe 5-10 minutes a game. It was something small.
Well, speaking of you seeing him on the court, you're going to see him at the court at the Garden soon in that tournament.
Yeah.
Kentucky gets put in a tournament with St. John's. LIU, Brooklyn, and Hofstra. I don't know how that worked out.
I mean, you know, St. John's is going to win, though, so we're good.
Yeah, okay.
We're good.
St. John's might lose to LIU, Brooklyn.
That's ridiculous.
LIU, Brooklyn's a ridiculous team. They made the tournament a couple times. They're not bad.
Okay, but they're not. St. John's is not.
St. John's, the 122nd ranked team in the country? That St. John's?
I don't care. Oh, yeah, and who's ranked how many spots higher? What's Iona?
20 spots higher.
20 spots higher. Oh.
You can have really down Iona at our campus.
Okay. No, I'm not. No, I just, I think you're shredding hot.
You'll get kicked off this radio show.
Treading thin ice with that. All right. I really do think that, I think that St. John's is not going to be bad. And I think that you're just being judgmental because you didn't choose St. John's and you chose Iona.
All right. Someone needs to get him out of the station.
No.
Anyway, my national championship pick, the Iona Hoosiers.
Hoosiers?
I mean, Indiana
Hoosiers.
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 Hoosiers. Not Iona Hoosiers. Indiana. Anyway, Yogi Ferrell's gone. He was the best player at Indiana
what
a very long time.
What team is he on? What NBA team is he on?
Don't quiz me on that.
What NBA team is he on?
I don't like basketball.
What NBA team is he on?
What team?
The Brooklyn Nets.
What, undrafted free agent or something?
No. Well, yeah, they drafted him, cut him, signed him.
Yeah, I hate the NBA. That's why we don't talk about it on the show, just saying.
Hey.
It's horrible. It's a good sport.
Curtis Jones, top freshman for Indiana. He played really well against Kansas in that upset win. And Kansas, Josh Jackson led them last night. Kansas upset Duke. Frank Mason came out, hit that mid-range shot with 2 seconds left, and Kansas beat the number one team, Duke. So Indiana beat Kansas in overtime proves that this is a good team this year. And it's going to be led by James Blackman Jr., who had the second most points on the team last year behind Yogi Ferrell. He put up 26 points against Kansas, and he looks really good so far. And he looked good last year, too.
So you're using the logic that if they beat them and they beat them, then they're better than the third team.
Yeah, and that logic works sometimes.
Sometimes. I don't know. I don't know.
Indiana's always a team that we expect big things out of them, and then
they
kind of fall
off. They always collapse, yeah.
But eventually, they have to get to the prominence because they're Indiana. And another team, prestigious history. All three teams we mentioned have really big history in college basketball.
St.
And
John's.
Indiana's the team out of those three that really have just not gotten the breaks of the other two.
Why can't we just bring back Lou? Baby Lou Carnesecca. God, that era is over. Are we going to...
Last thing we're going to talk about is the Big 12, because I am a Texas fan. And who will win the Big 12 this year? That's the question.
Not Texas.
You say you're big on Kansas, so go ahead.
Texas. I think Kansas is going to win.
Kansas wins every year.
Kansas is going to win again.
It's time for change.
It's okay.
And press Virginia.
So you're saying Trump wins the presidency, anything could happen, right?
Well, ask Dwayne The Rock Johnson about that.
I'm not going to talk about politics. Come on.
Anyway, West Virginia, they bring back Dexter Miles Jr., but they don't have enough to make a run this year, I don't think. They're projected third in the conference. Probably West Virginia. It's where my uncle went to school. It's probably where.
What does that have to do with
it? I just want to throw that out there.
Nobody cares.
Sorry. Anyway, that's probably where they're going to end up, third. The three teams that I think can compete for this conference are Iowa State, Kansas, and Texas. Iowa State loses Georges Niang, who's been the best player of that team for a long time, but they bring back Monte Morris, who is a really big Walker candidate right now. Top player in college basketball, in case you didn't realize.
No, I know that.
Yeah. Well, Monte Morris comes back. I don't know how the rest of the team around him is yet. I haven't really saw this team play. But Iowa State, always a contender. Monte Morris, one of the best draft prospects. We'll see what they could do. That leaves Texas and Kansas, though. The two teams I think will compete for it. And Texas is a really big X-factor team this year. Even though I'm a fan of them, I mean this as just watching them play. Because they're a really, really young team. They lose everybody. They lost Connor Lambert last year, Isaiah Taylor, Jonathan Holmes, Cameron Ridley, and Prince Ibe. I mean, the whole team's gone. But they bring in Jared Allen and Andrew Jones. Two five-star prospects. Jared Allen, number one five-star prospect on this team for sure. Andrew Jones, he bounces from between a 4 and a 5. No one really knows what he is. You look at different websites, you're going to see different things. But also, Kerwin Roach and Tevin Mack, they got suspended the first game. That's why we struggled against Incarnate Word. They come back next game, lose Atlanta Monroe, and they blow them out. The point is, this team is really, really deep with talent, but they just might be too young to make a run. Yeah. But Shaka Smart, one of the best coaches in college basketball, if he could bring all this talent together, they definitely can compete with Kansas this year.
Do you think by the time we graduate college, depending on if you're in a master's program or in like a four-year program, do you think Texas has a chance?
At the conference or the national title?
National title.
If Jared Allen or Andrew Jones decides to stay next year and the team matures around them and they bring in one more five-star recruit, why not?
All right, I'm gonna test this too. Do you think Texas football has a chance to win a national title by the time we leave college?
Definitely.
Definitely.
As soon as next year.
Oof.
I think you're insane. Have you seen how bad they've been?
I've seen Deontay Foreman become a Heisman candidate.
Okay.
And I've seen Shane Buechel mature throughout the year.
Your coach is like...
Well, Chazzy Strong needs to get out of here.
Yeah.
But...
Yeah, him and Todd Bowles are like the same freaking coach. It's insane.
Listen, at least Strong brings the core values to Texas.
What core values? What core?
No drinking. No fighting. That's about it. He doesn't do anything with football.
You want to know why he doesn't do anything with football? He just throws his kids out on the field. He goes, go ahead, kids. Play. Win a game for us. Coach, should we kick a field goal here? I don't know. It's up to you.
The sad thing is, he was pretty good at Louisville with Teddy Bridgewater. I don't know what happened here.
Teddy Bridgewater is a completely different type of quarterback.
He has so much talent around him, too. Just again, Texas is young in football, too. Just a young team. Every single sport, they're a young team. Women's volleyball, though, check them out. National title contenders every year. Hook them. Well, that's going to end it for this segment. We'll be back for hockey in a minute.
Oh, my God.
We'll be back.
Oh, my God.